Welcome to the first episode of New Items Unpacked in English Language. In this series, I'll show you what I bought for my collection or for resale purposes. I'd be happy if you like my video, write a comment or subscribe to my channel. Let's go. The first item this month is from a guy who really likes his games to be sent perfectly safe. Look how much tape he used and what a hard time I have opening it. Still busy opening it. Almost 1 minute in and still couldn't open it. This is tedious. I hate this. And I hate the seller for it. And I hate myself. And you. Okay, I finally did it. What we've got here is the Mask Game Euro-1 version in very good condition. I already have the game, so this was meant as a quality upgrade. As you can see here, the copy I had in my collection had a few flaws. Some signs of storage here and there, and the most important thing, the poster was missing. Now it's all in a great shape and includes the poster. The next item is a shipment from Sweden. The packaging is the opposite of what we saw before. Very risky to ship a game worth $80 in a paper envelope. Lucky it worked out and it arrived here without any damage. The item I bought is called Illusion of Time, Dutch version. I bought this for the Swedish manual in black and white. The Scandinavian PAL code is by far my favorite. That's why I started collecting all these tiny black and white manuals that Bergsala added to such a variety of games. Here it is, the Swedish booklet. The next shipment looks like a bunch of manuals. The first two manuals are for SimCity 2000. Then there is Waterworld, Super Swift, Plock, Super R-Type and Jurassic Park. Jurassic Park is needed in order to complete my UK version. At the moment I don't have many cartridge bags. I have many games that don't have one yet. I need to get one before I can add them to my collection. I never add incomplete games. Look at this copy of SimCity 2000. It's in a bad condition and of course not the one of my collection. It's a copy which I want to sell. But it didn't have a manual, yet. So that's why I bought a manual separately. Now I can take photos of it and sell it. Let's see what we've got here. It's a small box and it includes a loose cartridge. Fighter Alpha 2. Now I forgot to prepare the box and manual which I bought this cartridge for. Wait a moment, please. I had to go to my second Nintendo room. Here it is. Street Fighter Alpha 2 box and manual. German version. Now it's complete and will be prepared for sale. Let's move on to the next parcel for today. Look at the box. It has a huge dent here. I hope that the contents is unharmed. Let me open it quickly for you. It's NBA All-Star Challenge. And I bought it for my collection. The special thing about it is that it's the Euro version. I already have the German, UK and French Dutch versions of it. Here you can see the other versions. What we've got here is a purchase from Sweden. Usually I don't buy Nintendo Entertainment System games, but here I did it for the Bird Soliflyer. This golf game is a shitty PAL, A, version, but it cost only 3 euros. When I bought Snake's Revenge, I didn't see that the manual was missing. I was too greedy for the Berg Soliflyer. But if I had seen the missing manual, I would have bought it anyway. So fuck it. The question is if I should try to find a manual or try to sell it like it is. At this point I wanted to show you my extra consumer information leaflets. I like to have some extra ones so that I can complete a game. I never add incomplete games to my collection. So having some consumer information leaflets left is a good thing. Here you can see some torn apart leftovers of bird sala flyers. Of course I cannot use them for my collection. I also cannot throw them into the trash because hey, it's Nintendo. As you can see right now I don't have any extra bird sala flyers. So with the help of this Snake's Revenge purchase I can buy a new Scandinavian game that lacks the Bergsala flyer. Let's switch to the next purchase. I bought this on German eBay and I can guarantee you that it's a highlight purchase. Holy shit. Look at this cunt. He did not put any extra material into the parcel that would have been able to stop the games from moving. What an asshole. What we've got here is a Saturday Night Slam Masters in very good condition. I am a bit disappointed about the condition. It looked better in the photos. Let's have a comparison with the one from my collection. Maybe I can upgrade a single part or maybe more. I think I'm gonna keep my old box. Let's compare the cartridges. Holy shit, the cartridge bag isn't even original. Bah. Man, that fake cartridge bag confused me that much so that I compared the manuals first. Can you see it? The new manual is clearly better than the old one. Success. My old cartridge is better than the new one. Well, at least I could upgrade a single part, the manual. Still disappointed though. Depending on how much of a crazy collector you are, a Saturday Night Slam Masters game complete in box is more or less a highlight. For me personally, the next game is even better. On the first glimpse it looks very boring and common. Royal Rumble? But let's have a closer look. It's the French/Dutch version. And it's the -1 version. I didn't know that it even existed. Man, that was a good purchase. I still don't have the original FAH edition though, but imagine if this was the original version. How would I know that a -1 even existed? So this was great, because not only did I get a new game for my collection, but I also expanded my knowledge on Super Nintendo games. The overall condition of the game can be described as very good. It comes with consumer information leaflet and another fake cartridge bag. What a letdown. Currently I am having a drought of original cartridge bags. Here I ordered 5 games from France. All 5 games are low tier collector's items, but I still don't own them in my collection. Chess Master, NHL 95, NHL Hockey 94, FIFA Road to World Cup 98 and PGA Tour Golf. Let's start with PGA Tour Golf. Overall good condition, but no consumer information leaflet, no cartridge bag and a non-original cartridge tray. Let me just quickly exchange it with an original one and add a consumer information leaflet. I chose the consumer information leaflet based on the condition of the game. Very good condition means good leaflet. Worse condition means worse leaflet. FIFA also lacks the cartridge bag, and also has a fake cartridge tray. Look at this. This cunt has colored the tears of the box. He tried to cover it up. What a dickhead. Next up, NHL 94. Same as before, no dust bag, no original tray. Wow, would you look at this? A cart bag? And it's original? Wow, I can add one of the 5 games to my collection. Great success. This was game number 239 in my collection of French/Dutch games and number 1642 Super Nintendo PAL game. Every game that I get new to my collection will be put into such a new and unused protector box. I often get games in protectors added by the sellers. I would never add those protectors to my collection, because I don't want used ones and I don't want protectors from another style. They all have to be the same. The protector then gets an end label. That shows me which PAL code the game has. The final game of this purchase is the Chess Master. No cartridge bag, no original cartridge tray again. Enough said. Now I have 60 to 70 French/Dutch games left to collect. Some of the missing ones are really tough to get. And expensive. For example, the Death and Return of Superman or Turtles Tournament Fighters. I already have a lot of the rare and expensive ones. Like Arrow the Acrobat 2, Demon's Crest, Fatal Fury 2, Harvest Moon, both Pocky and Rocky games, Soul Blazer, Super Widget, Turtles in Time, Zero the Kamikaze Squirrel and Super Soccer. Ha. This next purchase was a great one. Even though it could have been much better. I again, as I often do, bought a game that I already have. I should be a lot more careful when bidding. You should never buy from your memory. Always check your collections list. Here it is, Jurassic Park, French version. As you can see here, I already have it, and in better condition. I couldn't even exchange a single part. This really was a dumb purchase. I couldn't expand my collection. I couldn't improve the condition of a game I already have, and I cannot make money by reselling it. The other game that came with this purchase is great though. Pop and Twinbee French/Dutch version. I already have it in my collection, but it's really rare and expensive, and I got it via the German eBay for only 60 euros. And the best thing is that I could improve the condition of my manual and cartridge. Even though the box has its flaws, both the manual and the cartridge are close to perfect. I put them together with the box I had before, and now I have a close to perfect copy of the game in my collection and a slightly worse one for resale. I am sure that I can make some good money off of it. I ordered these two games here from the same guy where I bought Saturday Night Slam Masters and WWF Royal Rumble. Seems like he learned that the games need some extra material, so that they don't fly around inside the box. I bought the Smurfs Travel the World in the German version and OE, no dash 1. It's the rare version and I didn't have it in such a good condition. The other game is NBA Jam Tournament Edition. Whenever I receive a new order, I will always check if one of the parts of the new game is in better condition than the one I have in my collection. Like this, I can upgrade the condition of my own games a lot. Here you can see me doing a comparison of all the separate parts and picking the better one every time. My copy of NBA Jam Tournament Edition also has the Swedish extra manual in full color, that Berg Sala added to it. That's why it also includes a Berg Sala registration flyer. Sometimes it's a tough decision. When a box has a flaw on one side of it, and the new box has a flaw on the other side, what should I do? So sometimes after I made the decision, I change my mind and keep the other piece. In the case of NBA Jam Tournament Edition, I kept the new box and manual and the old cartridge. For the Smurfs game, I just kept the new box and all the old parts. Another good thing about this order was the fact that I got two new original cartridge bags. Now I can add the Chessmaster and FIFA 98 games, both French versions, to my collection. You know, I never add incomplete games to my collection. Here you can see that the decision was easy. The old box was much worse than the new one. The contents of the box, on the other hand, was in better condition than the new parts. As I said in the beginning, there are two dash versions of the German Smurf game, NOE and NOE-1. If you are interested in the comparison of different game versions, check out my new video series called, What's the Effin' Difference? In that series, I pick a game that I have two or more different dash versions of, and then do a side-by-side comparison to see where exactly the difference is. I have just started it, so there aren't that many episodes so far. But give me some time and it will quickly add up. Sometimes buying Super Nintendo games is like masturbating to porn. When you finish, you feel regret and you wish you had picked something else. Here I bought two sets of boxes and manuals for Donald and Maui Mallard and Super Mario Kart. Why? Don't know. I couldn't improve the condition of any of those games. What a waste. At least I got two original cartridge bags. So I got that going for me, which is nice. The next purchase is easy. I have a fair share of games that are incomplete. Some lack a cartridge, some lack the manual. Here I bought a cartridge of Pack in Time. Now I have completed the game. Right now as I am doing this video, I have already sold the complete game to an Austrian customer. The next two purchases came today. Both are new games for my collection. The first one is an Italian game. It's my 95th Italian game so far. Joe and Mac, Caveman Ninja. The consumer information leaflet is wrong. It's UKV, but it has to be EDA. At least the cartridge bag is original. So let me quickly grab one of those extra leaflets I keep lying around. Like this, the game will be complete and can be added to my collection. I try not to forget to check the manual. Sometimes I find things inside. For example, an original receipt. Or a small extra manual in black and white. But most of the time I find writings inside. I hate that. Now let me quickly assemble this game, so that I can start with the next game. You'll like it. The next game for my collection is Goof Troop, the Spanish version, and it's in excellent condition. And I paid a shitload of money for it, 200 euros. But that doesn't make it the most expensive Goof Troop game of my collection. For the Scandinavian version I paid more than 300 euros. Man, I need a psychologist. At least I got the correct consumer information leaflet and an original cartridge bag for the money. Thank you. The last purchase of September 2020 is a very special one. Finding a game like this is super hard. Let's see. Super Probotector? What can be special about Super Probotector? First I gotta get this shit out of the protector box. Man, I hate those protectors that have this tiny thing at the end. I can never get them open properly. To the trash with you, you twat. Here, have a look at all Super Probotectors I have accumulated over the years. Which version could the new one be? FRG No-1? Or maybe ESP? Or is it the Australian version? No, it's even better. As you can see from the gray color on the flaps, it's the GPS version. And the best thing about it is, that it does contain an original cartridge bag and the extra full color manual in Portuguese language. It doesn't include a GPS consumer information leaflet though. But that's not much of a problem because I have some extra ones lying around. This year I have found only two new GPS games, this and SimCity. GPS games are so tough to find. Welcome to your new family. A family of Super Probotector games. Standing in my shelf. Forever. And ever. Alone. In the dark. Haha.